Assalamu alaikum, everyone. After spending a while on YouTube, we felt that we wanted to interact more with you guys. So guess what? We now have a Twitter account. We'll be posting updates, announcements, interesting educational nuggets every now and then, so make sure you follow us at ATP_EDU. And share our account with everyone you know, because we are going global, baby. And back to the video.
Welcome back to another ATP video. Today, we'll be talking about Borrelia burgdorferi. It'll be a short and concise video, so we hope you find it beneficial. To give a brief overview, Borrelia species are irregular, loosely coiled spirochetes that are transmitted by ticks known as exudus capillaris. The most important thing to remember about this type of bacteria is that it causes Lyme disease. Now let us dig a little bit deeper and talk about its important features. Most Borrelia species are obligate anaerobes, and they have an outer membrane that contains a substance similar to lipopolysaccharides. They also have an inner membrane and a layer of peptidoglycan in periplasmic space, which classifies them as gram-negative. However, this result is not easily visualized using the regular gram stain. And as we previously mentioned in the introduction, Borrelia species are spirochetes, meaning that they are spirally shaped bacteria. They have axial filaments that facilitate their movement. Keep in mind that Borrelia are not the only existing spirochetes. We also have Leptospira and Treponema. However, only Borrelia can be visualized in light microscopy using either Wright or GIMSA stain, and that's due to their big size. After knowing about the special features of these bacteria, the question now is, what enables them to cause disease? The answer is so simple. Remember that we've mentioned that Borrelia are transmitted by ticks. Thus, the organism spreads from the site of the bite through the surrounding skin and then it disseminates via the blood, causing bacteremia to various organs, especially the heart, joints, and the central nervous system. However, there are no excitotoxins, enzymes, or other virulence factors that have been identified so far for this organism. Borrelia is transmitted by ticks known as exudus capillaris, or simply the deer tick, which are also the vector for anaplasma species and the protozoa Babesia. The natural reservoir for this organism is mice, and although deer are the obligatory hosts, they do not harbor Borrelia. We've stated previously that Borrelia causes Lyme disease, which is also known as Lyme borreliosis. The disease occurs worldwide, and it's the most common tick-borne disease in the United States, especially in the northeastern region. Now we'll talk about the signs and symptoms of Lyme disease, which can be divided into three stages. In stage 1, which is the early localized stage, erythema migrans represents the most common finding, which is an expanding erythematous macular rash that often has a target or bullseye appearance. Keep in mind that although this bullseye configuration is pathognomic for Lyme disease, it's not always present. Moreover, the rash at this stage may sometimes be accompanied by nonspecific flu-like symptoms, such as fever and chills. In stage 2, which is the early disseminated stage, carditis, AV block, facial nerve, or also known as Bell's palsy, and migratory myalgias / transient arthritis are the most prominent findings during the stage. Furthermore, secondary lesions could arise, but they are not as important. And lastly, stage 3, which is the late disseminated stage. It is characterized by encephalopathy and chronic arthritis that usually affects the larger joints such as the knees. We all know right now that Lyme disease is caused by bacteria. However, culturing the organism in order to reach the diagnosis is not the answer. Yes, the organism can be grown in the lab. However, cultures are rarely positive and hence are not usually performed. The diagnosis is typically made serologically by detecting either IgM or IgG antibodies using ELISA. However, because there are problems with the specificity and sensitivity of these tests, a positive test result should be confirmed with Western blotting. The treatment of choice for stage 1 disease or other mild manifestations is either doxycycline or amoxicillin. Doxycycline is contraindicated in children aged less than 8 years and pregnant women. It can slow bone growth in exposed fetuses and causes enamel hypoplasia and permanent teeth stains during tooth development in young children. Therefore, oral amoxicillin is the treatment of choice for children and pregnant women. However, for more severe forms or late-stage disease, ceftriaxone is recommended. We've discussed everything about Borrelia. Now the question is, how can we prevent it? In the past, there was a vaccine containing a recombinant outer surface protein, OSPA for short, for Borrelia burgdorferi. However, this vaccine has been withdrawn. The only preventive measures that one can take are wearing protective clothing and using insect repellents, especially in the areas where the disease is known to be common. Alright, to sum up, today we talked about Borrelia burgdorferi. We have said this organism belongs to spirochetes, and it can be visualized under the light microscope using either right or gym sustain. It's transmitted by deer ticks, and it primarily causes Lyme disease, which can be identified serologically and with Western blotting. Treatment choices include doxycycline or amoxicillin, and ceftriaxone can be used for severe form of disease. And that's it for Borrelia. We hope you found it interesting. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to receive our latest explanations. And as always, thanks for watching.